How's it going, everybody? I'm Rob DeMello, and welcome to Cover 2, Hawaii High School Football Weekly. In just a few moments, we go student body right as Cover 2 analyst Brian Teo joins us as we preview the marquee matchup in Week 7 in the 808 prep schedule with a mix of coaches, players, and analysts breaking down more than half of the 20-weekend game. Sam Spangler takes us to Kalai Pohaku, where the Crusader quarterbacks are the epitome of the St. Louis Brotherhood, and Kanoa Lehi goes one-on-one with Kamehameha Maui head coach Cody Nakamura. But first, we get this party started by taking a look at the latest Cover 2 Power Poll. And we start in Division 1, where the biggest leap was made by the Red Raiders of Kahuku. First-year head coach Lee Leslie and company jumped two spots to third after improving to 4-0 with a 56-19 win at Castle, capped by Seimisi Kauwaka's 55-yard pick six. Numbers 1 and 2 remain the same, with Punahou and Mililani holding things down, with Kahuku's jump both the Govs and Warriors down a spot. 6 through 9 has the Mules, Sabres, Vikings, and Crusaders. Maui dropped two spots to 10 after a loss to Lahaina Luna. And speaking of the Lunas, Big Red solidified their stance at the top of Division 2, going from 13 first-place votes to 19 following their 14-zip win over the Sabres, extending their MIL winning streak to 12 games. Undefeated Pearl City swapped spots with Iulani after the Raiders lost to St. Louis. 4 and 5 stayed true, with the Golden Hawks and Warriors both winning over the weekend. Now I want to welcome to the show Cover 2 analyst, former Punahou running backs coach Brian Teo. And coach, quick examination of the D2 rankings. Kapaa in at number 5 after a big win over reigning league champion Kauai. When you look at the three-team KIF, do you think that they could be at a disadvantage as the season rolls on, being that they play the same two teams three times throughout league play?
I think one could argue that theoretically there might be a disadvantage. You're limited to the amount of looks you can have in a particular season. You have two teams you're playing, so you're not going to see as many schemes. You're not going to see as many different variations of a certain offense. So absolutely, I think there might be some disadvantages in postseason.
And one could argue that others are at a disadvantage. Kauai reached the state title game last season. You could argue that the teams that are about to face the KIF teams, they haven't seen much tape of these teams facing multiple looks, so it's harder for them to prepare, right?
Exactly, and you don't know who's going to step on the field. I mean, Kauai did shock Oahu when they stepped on the field, and they looked like a typical Kahuku team, and you know, no one was expecting that.
Well, Kapaa at 2-1, only loss came to number 1 Lahaina Luna by just 2 points earlier this season. The Warriors are tough. They'll get Waimea Saturday, but we start our marquee matchups in the OIA. And that's where in Division 1's Big Bad Blue, a pair of unbeatens will square off in Ever Beach, as 7th-ranked Campbell will play host to number 2 Mililani. Now Sabres enter the game riding high on a last-minute victory over Kapolei, while the Trojans have been laying teams out, sporting a 6-0 record, winning by an average score of 42-14. Now perhaps the most intriguing element in this game is awaiting the collision of next-level talents in Mililani junior running back Vavai Malepeai and Sabres senior safety Solomon Matautia.
Oh yeah, I mean, both of the kids go good, over 6 foot type builds, and they're next level already. You know, I've seen those kids. Solomon's a good size safety, linebacker, whatever you're gonna say. I mean, he's got some natural abilities. His footwork, you know, is very impressive. A lot of coaches have talked highly about him, and it's gonna be real interesting to see that matchup. You know, him chasing Lavi around the field will be something that'll be special, something that everybody will want to tune into.
I've always said the way you slow down speed is by hitting him, not tackling, but hitting him. If you can make him a mental game, if he fears you when he tries to get the ball again and you just keep going at him and going at him and going at him, that's the only way you're going to stop him. As soon as he runs you over, cuts the corner and burns you, you're done.
So, coach, as fellow La'ie native Leonard Peters alluded to, from the safety standpoint of how you try and control Malepeai, as a former running back yourself, what needs to be the plan of attack for Vavai and the Trojan offense? As far as when you know the last line of defense is a punisher like Solomon Matautia.
Rule number 1, don't be there when Solomon gets there. You need to be somewhere else, because he's going to lay the hammer. So, but at the same time, we don't coach the running backs to worry about the third level. We're worried about the front line. We're worried about the linebackers. And then hopefully through luck, they'll make it past the secondary. So just try not to be there when Solomon Mataltio comes down the pike.
That's wise advice right there. Talking passing game now. Mackenzie Milton, extremely accurate and poised, the Mililani quarterback. He's also dangerous with his legs. Now, how do you try and keep the QB under control in a big game like this if you're the Campbell Sabres?
You want to keep him in the pocket. You want to force him to go to his second and third option. You know, it's a lot easier for him to make a decision, look for his first option, make that pass and be successful, and then try to extend the play by using his legs. But if you can force him to stay in the pocket, kind of similar to what the San Diego Chargers did to all the Seahawks.
You sound like a father of the San Diego Charger.
But, you know, they did that to Russell Wilson, limiting him to his second and third reads. And, you know, at 5'11 with 6'7 linemen, it's a little hard to see over the line when you're that small.
And by doing that, they controlled most of the game as far as time of possession. You just want to keep Mackenzie Milton off the field if he's that good and that dangerous.
Yeah, the colder he gets, the more successful you'll be.
So Austin May, Terrell Johnson, running backs for Campbell, they can play a big part in that as far as extending this game, keeping Mililani off the field. All right, no doubt the game of the year thus far in the OIA. Last season, Sabres lost a 21-7 halftime lead to Mililani in a 42-21 Trojan win. Kickoff is set for Friday, 7:30, and will be televised on OC16, Channel 12. All right, first quarter in the books here on Cover 2. When we come back, the Chargers of Pearl City rush off a pop quiz. Why any turbulence at Radford will be straightened out with a smile. But first, Sam Spangler introduces us to a pair of wingmen who are soaring side by side.
That's right, Rob. We're heading up St. Louis Heights Drive feeling like we're on top of the world. Coming up a little later, we'll show you how the Saints are marching back up the slope of Kalaipohaku, despite their star quarterback tumbling down the depth chart. You're watching Cover 2.